I'm an Agile nerd, so I'm always looking at two or three side topics of research. Last month, one of those topics was comparing and contrasting the different scaling methodologies. I was reading Jeff Sutherland's guide for Scrum at Scale, and in there he says that the optimum Agile team is somewhere between 3 and 9 people. Now, I remember when I was trained a long time ago in my very first Scrum Master course that the optimal team size was 7 plus or minus 2. And that's a number I hear most people throw around. So when I saw the range 3 to 9 as opposed to 7 to 9, it gave me a new topic to look into. The Scrum at Scale guide uses the number 4.6 for the perfect team size. That seems rather specific and impossible.
I never seen one, Paul.
Never seen one what?
A half a boy.
Well, it's not really a half a boy, it's a ratio.
Horatio who?
Not whole ratio, a ratio. It's mathematics, arithmetic. Look, now, Opie, just forget that part of it. Forget the part about the half a boy.
It's pretty hard to forget a thing like that, Paul.
I found many opinions out there from experts and so-called experts. Some referred to Amdahl's law and Parkinson's law and got really fancy, but in the end, the result was an opinion. I found people saying the perfect size was 2, 3, 4, 5, and of course 7. There's a really good study more than 10 years ago working with real Agile teams doing real work. Now, the summary for that study concludes on a specific team size range. But as I dug a little bit deeper and looked at the data, I saw the real range, depending on what you wanted to maximize, was between 3 on the low end and 15 on the high end. Well, 3 to 15 isn't really a good guideline. That's quite broad. Now, my experience working in multiple industries in many different countries and doing different disciplines is that there can't be a one size fits all that is applicable in every situation. So I was skeptical from the beginning. The source for the magical 7 number is referenced in the Scrum Guide published way back in 2013, which I thought I had read, but maybe I wasn't really paying attention. In there it says that the perfect size of an Agile team is between 3 and 9. But in the footnote, it brings us back to a study from 1956 in the Psychological Review. That's the paper that has the magic 7 plus or minus 2. The problem is, not only weren't they thinking about Agile, they weren't even looking at team size. They were looking at attention and short-term memory. So I really don't know how applicable that number is to our topic. Jeff Sutherland's guide of Scrum at Scale has a footnote to a study in 1970. That paper is by Hackman and Vidmar, and it does look at trying to find the optimal size of team for work. Now, it was conducted at 2 different universities and seems to be quite a rigorous academic research document. But the conclusions are not what you'd expect. In it, they say that size doesn't matter. The exact quote is, "Size had negligible effects on performance." What did have effect on performance? The type of work being done and the groups that they looked at. The conclusion isn't that there's an optimal team size. The conclusion is it depends. I had a Scrum team of 16 people in 16 different locations across 4 time zones. Now, all of the experts would predict that would be a disaster. But in only 6 months, their improvement was so dramatic that ITSMA, the IT Services Marketing Association, gave them their gold award for agility. I'll tell you how they did it in a future blog about collaboration. The correct size for a team is going to depend upon the work that they're doing and the people that are there. It's called agility, not rigidity. That means you're going to need to be flexible, sometimes team to team, on who's included, the size, and how they function.
You need to be skillful, agile, and above all, you need to be fast. You should be able to shrink and grow on a dime, so your size always suits your needs.
So while size may not matter, the important stuff does. The work that you're doing and the people that are doing it.